So no matter what kind of wheat system we're going into, whether we're grazing and harvesting or maybe doing both, the best thing we want to do is start clean. We know that our crop is going to be the most competitive if it's not competing for resources with other weed species. So starting clean is great. If you are open to tillage, some kind of mechanical operation is a great strategy. So we're not always relying just on herbicides, but herbicides work as well as a burn down treatment.
So now's the time that people should be thinking about their applications. Important dates are coming up. What advice do you have for producers going forward?
So if you are burning down with a non-selective herbicide like glyphosate and you're tank mixing with any synthetic auxins like 2,4-D and dicamba, be cautious about some of those plant back intervals. We do have some timing windows that we need to meet before we plant wheat. And also be thinking about, is this a crop you're gonna possibly take off in the summer, or are you gonna graze it out? If it's something we're gonna harvest, our weed management might be a little bit more intensive.
As we're moving into fall, the weather's gonna be changing. It's been pretty wet this past summer, but as things change, how is that gonna affect the way that producers go about applications this year?
So many of our summer annual species are finishing their life cycle. The weeds that are gonna be the most problematic in winter wheat are gonna be our winter annuals. Many of our grasses, broadleafs, those plants are going to wait until we cool down for them to germinate. So if we're planting and it's still kind of warm, it just really depends on the fall. We have temperatures that are still in the low 70s, which can happen. A lot of our winters aren't going to be quite up out of the ground yet. So we need to be paying attention to when they do germinate and just making sure that we make timely applications.
The price of feed has been going up quite dramatically over the past year, and some people may be thinking of moving to dual purpose. What advice do you have for producers that are, maybe it's their first time considering dual purpose? What do you have for them?
So for those from a weed management perspective, if maybe you're a producer who hasn't taken your grain off in the summer and you've mostly grazed out or terminated, there is an application timing that we call delayed pre, which is shortly after the wheat comes up. And we have some pre-emergence herbicides, delayed pre, that we can use at that timing. That is a good time to control grasses, so you can be thinking about harvesting clean grain in the summer.
And then you've got some fact sheets available for people who are making these kinds of decisions right now.
Yeah, we'll link some. I think a few that would be important at this time. We have one on tank mix considerations, and then also another one on those delayed pre-emergence products.
All right, thank you, Misha. Dr. Misha Manuchehri, Extension Weed Specialist here at Oklahoma State University.